a street food cart that sells pizza pakwan, that is poha with matri and dal. This one was a perfect street fusion food. So it's a quite an interesting fusion of Sindhi food with the like MP food, you can say the food of Central India. The fresh malpua is being made here. The batter is made up of rubbery dense condensed milk with white flour and then the deep fried in ghee, that's clarified butter. Once it is fried, then they are dipped in the sugar syrup. So Pushkar is the land of malpua. You see in this lane, the Halwai Gali, most of the shops, they sell malpua with rubbery. You have falafel. There's a patty of chickpea and some potato wedges. Some more salt, pepper, and it's done. Wow. Wow, that's huge. I don't know how he's going to roll it. I have never tried such a huge paratha in my life. It's really the calorie-rich paratha you can ever have anywhere in India. On the streets of Pushkar, you can come and try the really special paratha cooked in ghee with cheese, cottage cheese, onion, tomatoes, and spices. Hello everyone, I'm Anubhav Sapra from Delhi Food Box. I am in Pushkar, the temple town and the holy city in Ajmer district of Rajasthan. As usual, we are here for street food exploration. Let's go and explore. Pushkar is a beautiful, colorful and a small city in the center east part of Rajasthan on the western side of Aravali Mountains. It is located on the shore of Pushkar Lake, which has many ghats where pilgrims bathe. Pushkar has become a place of Hindu pilgrimage because of this holy lake. Legend has it that this lake was consecrated to Lord Brahma, the creator of the universe, when a lotus dropped from his hand into the veil and a lake emerged in that place. The most important temple in Pushkar is the temple of Lord Brahma, one of the holy trinity of Hinduism. I'm really excited to meet my friend from Jaipur. His name is Vinayak. He's coming all the way for a street food tour in Pushkar. Pushkar is an ideal place for a street food walk. The whole city can be covered in a couple of hours on foot. In fact, if you walk consciously, watching around, there's a chance that you will start recognizing the faces of the locals. This is what happened with me when I visited Pushkar last week. After one round of the city, I can recall and recognize most of the places and people. That's the beauty of a small city. The food journey in Pushkar started with the Pushkar breakfast corner near Varaghat. So what are we going to have first?
So first we are going to try poha pakwan, which you can also say like a pizza pakwan. It is a combination or a fusion of two dishes of poha and dal pakwan.
Oh, let's go and explore. Yeah. A street food cart that sells pizza pakwan, that is poha with matri and dal. This one was a perfect street fusion food. Dal pakwan is an authentic Sindhi breakfast dish where big size matri made up of maida is served with dal. And poha, that is flattened rice cooked with mustard seeds, is a famous breakfast of North India.
So he's there only for 4 hours in the morning. He comes at 6 o'clock and by 10 it's over.
So if you're planning to come to Pushkar, you have to make sure that you're here before 10 o'clock. Pushkar Breakfast Corner simply combined both of them, dal pakwan and poha, and named it pizza pakwan. The base is of a matri. Over it he evenly spreads poha, then adds dal. Top it with sev, namkeen, onion, chutney, chaat masala and fresh coriander. It was a simple twist given to the dish which tasted amazing. The crunchiness of the matri with light and fluffy poha blended perfectly. The crisps on the top like fried peanuts and sev added a spicy twist to it. So it's a quite an interesting fusion of Sindhi food with the like MP food, you can say the food of Central India. So. So it's a very healthy breakfast, it's a wholesome breakfast. We will get to eat the lentils, that's dal. Then poha is very light, lightly spiced. And then you add some chutney and masala over it. You can see, this is a small piece of matri. It's simply delicious. It's just like you get the crust is quite crisp. Then poha is soft
and then the dal. So that's the poha. That's made up of flattened rice. It's adding salt, chaat masala, cumin powder, some namkeen, chopped onions, and tomato. Some coriander. Giving some lemon. Wow. Here we have the traditional poha of Pushkar. Get the crisps of the namkeen and the soft poha with mustard seeds and lemon. It gives a different texture and flavor to it. It's quite light breakfast in the morning time. It's mostly popular in central India, but I'm surprised to find it in Rajasthan. It's a very popular dish here. It's there only in the morning time from 6 to 10 o'clock. You can come in the morning and try this super delicious yum poha, the light breakfast of Pushkar. It was a great start to Pushkar street food exploration. Let's go and try some more.
Just on a walking distance is another shop that opens up only in the morning time.
Next, we are going to try the other traditional breakfast of Pushkar, that's pakodi with kadi.
Pushkar Chaat Bhandar, also known as Mohanji Bhujia Wale. They are famous for pakodi, also known as bhujia here. The shop is run by father-son duo Mohanji and Kamal. A normal small bite-sized pakodi, that is fritters of spinach and besan, are topped with curry. Not to be confused with curry. The way curry is prepared in this part of Rajasthan is completely different from other parts of India. It is simply made up of besan and water. The combination of curry with pakori is quite unique to Ajmer district of Rajasthan.
So here we are having pakori and curry. This pakori is made up of spinach and bottle gourd, and then over it they add some curry. This curry is made up of chickpea flour. There is no use of yogurt or buttermilk in this curry. And over it they add some chutney. It's basically small pakora, it's like big size fritters. Pakori is small size fritters. They make it of spinach and they also add bottle gourd. There's ghee. So the pakori is made up of ghee and palak, and over it they add curry over it. It's simply amazing. So normally people eat pakodi with chutney. Here they eat it with curry. It's quite special. It's quite light because when you make small pakodis, the pakodi can absorb the curry and becomes quite soft. It's not spicy at all. It's super flavorful. It's very light on spices. They have added some rye, mustard seeds in it. And then they have added two different kinds of chutney, the spicy chutney, the green chutney and the sweet chutney. But it's very light. So if you try the pakodi, you have to make sure that you are here before 10 o'clock. Because after 10, you won't get the pakodi or curry here. But they also have other dishes in the menu. They have kachori, samosa, aloo vada. But the real delicacy is pakodi and curry. Very good. Let's go and explore the next place.
After having curry pakori, we tried kachori with mango chutney at Ugmaji shop.
This is our next stop in Pushkar for street food. We are going to try Ugmaji ki kachori. This shop is famous for kachori and samosa. The kachoris here are made up of moong dal and they serve it with mango chutney. That's raw mango chutney. So let's try it.
The dough of refined flour is stuffed with dal ki pitti to be deep fried in oil. What makes it special is the thick mango chutney served with kachori. The kachoris were really crisp and flaky.
The dough which you are seeing, there are two different kinds of dough. That's made up of white flour, that's maida, and that's moong dal and besan, the chickpea flour. That's the filling with spices and garam masala, the whole coriander seeds, and then they are rolled and stuffed inside this the dough. Wow, it is simply amazing how they make it. But the filling is quite huge. It's not like a small little pitti. Dal pitti is quite huge pitti. Wow, that's huge, big size kachori. Moong dal kachori, stuffed with lentils and thick mango chutney. Yay! So that's the kachori is a specialty of Rajasthan. You go anywhere, you'll find the kachori. At some places, they are stuffed with onion and mashed potatoes. At some places, like mawa kachori with sugar syrup. Here, they are stuffed with moong dal. And it's like quite thick and big size kachori. Over it, they added some raw mango chutney, which is sweet and tangy in taste. Just see it, like how it looks. Wow. That's a big, huge size moong dal. That's a dal. The moong dal kachori with some aloo mashed potatoes in it. Wow. It's really yum. This chutney simply reminds me of my home. That's how my mom makes a chutney. It's like khatti meethi chutney. I mostly like it with paratha. This is the first time I'm trying it with kachori. It's like fried dumpling. Simply amazing. In fact, the spices also they have added in it. It's like the whole spices. You can see the whole coriander seeds in it. Then you have cardamom, all different spices mixed in this kachori, big huge size kachori. And you see there's a whole seed of coriander in it. So they add the whole spices. That gives a different texture, different taste to this kachori. So simply loving it. So you travel anywhere in India, from Varanasi to Mathura, to any temple town, you'll find the kachori. And every day is quite special. But here, it's very different. They've added, because of chutney, I think, the chutney is quite sweet and tangy in flavor. Simply delicious. Wow. Wow, they were simply amazing kachoris. Now go and let's check out other place.
Yeah, let's go.
Pushkar can be renamed as a city of Malpua. You can spot the Malpua shop every nook and corner of the city.
The fresh Malpua is being made here. The batter is made up of rubbery, that's condensed milk with white flour, and then the deep fried in ghee, that's clarified butter. Once it is fried, then they are dipped in the sugar syrup. So Pushkar is the land of Malpua. You see in this lane, the Halwai Gali, most of the shops, they sell Malpua with rubbery. Oh, you can see that's a sugar syrup, that's soaked in sugar syrup. The fresh Malpua.
What makes Pushkar Malpua special is the rubbery Malpua. Instead of adding water in the batter, condensed milk is added. That makes it nutty in taste.
We are going to try Malpua and rubbery at Sarvariya Mistral Manda. This is the most famous shop in Pushkar for Malpua and rubbery. Oh, it's super fresh. It's still hot. So it's like little pancake. Let's go and try it out. It's quite hot, still fresh and hot. Wow.
There are only few places where the rubbery is mixed in the dough to make the malpua. And it is Pushkar is one of those places.
Wow. So this is the place where the malpua is made up of rubbery. They don't only add white flour, so it's quite special. And it's like quite nutty in texture. It's quite thick because of the rubbery. And it's soaked in sugar syrup. It's like a fried pancake for me. It's quite nutty in texture, very sweet, but super delicious. Many people eat it with kalakand. You can add some more condensed milk, like milk solids in it. Then you roll it, then make a malpua roll and have it. But we are just trying it plain. This is the normal malpua. It's excellent. This lane is famous for halwai shops. Halwais are one that make the sweets, and they are all over India, but mostly you'll find them in the traditional old cities. And here they are famous for making malpuas. We have just tried the rabri malpua. It's super great, super yum. So you must come and try the rabri malpua at Sarvariya Mistan shop. Let's go and try the other places.
Most of the foreign tourists in Pushkar are from Middle East, and they have somewhat influenced the street food as well. There are three shops next to each other selling falafel, hummus and other Middle Eastern food. The most famous dish is the laffa.
This place is very famous for falafel roll and pizza roll. Oh, he's adding olive oil. Garlic paste. Onion, cabbage. Wow, so you can get the feel, the flavors of Israel on the streets of Pushkar. That's mushroom. For the piece of bread, he has added some garlic and hummus. You see. Now he's adding slice of cheese slice.
Yes.
Wow. This cheese.
इसमें नहीं है black pepper वगैरह. Black pepper.
That's black pepper.
Salt.
Chili sauce. That's tomato sauce. Oh, you see the cheese is melting. That's olives. You have falafel. That's a patty of chickpea. And some potato wedges. Wow. Some more salt, pepper, and it's done. Wow. Ban gaya. Some more olive oil. On both the sides. I'm sure it's going to be very delicious because you can see like what all they have added in it. There's a base, it's a bread, they added some hummus, garlic sauce, falafel, then you have potato wedges, cheese, loads of cheese, cabbage, onion, mushroom, olives, all of that. And now we're going to have it. I'm really excited to try it. Done. Salt, pepper. Here we go. Wow.
Should I come there?
You can see, that's the falafel. That's a patty made up of chickpea flour with potato wedges, loads of masala, pepper, salt, and cheese.
They have special garlic cheese, which is a specialty of entire Pushkar.
It's garlic cheese.
Garlic cheese.
Garlic cheese taste karayenge. Wow. It's a specialty of Pushkar, garlic cheese. So they make the cheese with garlic.
Yes. It's a funny thing that it's a trade secret of every person. It seems like that Pushkar as a whole has a secret, and they don't reveal it.
Yeah. It's quite a strong flavor of garlic in it.
Yeah.
You can see the fillings inside. We have cheese, tomatoes, olives, cabbage, mushroom, then the garlic sauce and the tomato sauce, all wrapped. It's really amazing. I really liked it. I think olives, it really adds to the flavor. It has a different taste to it. It's really good. Normally pizza is baked, but it's not a baked pizza, it's a pizza roll. Stuffed with loads of cheese, olives, cabbage, mushroom, garlic sauce, pepper, salt, all of that. Simply amazing.
And totally Indianized.
It's an Indian, the Pushkar version of pizza. So if you want to get the taste of Israeli food, the Middle Eastern food or Italian food on the streets of Pushkar, you can come to Ganga restaurant and try it out.
The next food stop was Makhaniya Gulkand Lassi at Kumavat Lassi Cart.
Here we are at Kumavat Makhaniya Lassi.
Yes.
So he is saying like they are going to try the Makhaniya Lassi with Gulkand.
Yes.
It's quite thick. I can see it's quite thick lassi. Wow. Just to keep it cool, they keep it in the ice box. They kept in the ice box, and now he is adding in clay cups. You have meaty lassi here.
Yes, sweet lassi.
Sweet lassi. Oh, that's the cream. That's the malai. The thick layer of malai over it.
Rabdi.
That's condensed milk.
Yes.
That's condensed milk. That's rabdi. Oh God. It's going to be really heavy. Now he's adding gulkan. That's gulkan. It looks very sweet. because of the sweet lassi, cream, rabri, and then you have gulkan. Oh. So gulkan is basically a rose flavored jam. It's made with rose petals and sugar. That's it. So if you travel anywhere in India, from north to south, from east to west, you'll get lassi. But the flavor, the making of lassi changes from one place to other place. If you go to Amritsar, they add a layer of butter in it. If you come to Delhi, you can try rose flavored lassi. If you go to like Varanasi, they make pomegranate lassi. If you go to Rajasthan in Jaipur, you'll get only the normal lassi. And when you come to Pushkar, you can try the special gulkan lassi. What they have done is that there's a layer of lassi, big lassi, and then you have cream, that's malai, then rabri, that's condensed milk, and then they have added some gulkan in it. Gulkan is basically rose flavored jam. So Pushkar is the largest producer of gulkan, that's rose flavored jam, anywhere in the world. And it's made up of pink rose,
yeah,
and red roses petals.
Yeah.
So we are going to try it. Let's just drink it. Cheers.
Okay, cheers.
They have given us the spoon, but we will simply. Mm. Mm. It's very refreshing. It's sweet because of gulkan. Wow. Gulkan adds a very different texture to it. You see, that's the gulkan. That's the rose petals. Mm. So you get this in Jaipur as well?
No, we don't get this in Jaipur.
No.
But Anubhav, tell me about it. Like, I feel that you are personally a lassi expert. Because wherever you go, you really love lassi.
That's true.
So this is something I'm pretty sure it must be really different because of the gulkan.
It's very different. Oh, you're saying that like you go anywhere in India, you can taste the yogurt-based drink. I've tried in Amritsar, was my favorite place, and at Jauja, I tried lassi with butter. And in Delhi, we get normal kesar pista lassi. In Varanasi, I have tried the makhan lassi, rabri lassi, and also pomegranate lassi with anar. In Jaipur, we tried a simple plain lassi with yogurt and sugar, that's it. And here we are trying another variety. And in fact, in Bhubaneswar also, we tried coconut lassi. So if you go travel anywhere, we can do a list of places to have lassi, yeah, all over India. We can do a lassi trail. So, but mark me, this is very special because of gulkan. I have already, like, I love paan. I'm sure many people who watch our videos would know about it, but I love paan, and in paan we normally add gulkan. This is the first time I'm trying it with lassi. So it's quite thick, it's quite rich because of rabri, malai and lassi, and then gulkan is quite sweet, but it's very special. Mm.
Next, we went on to try the golgappa at a street cart with six different flavors.
This is a very unique place in Pushkar where you can try six different flavors of pani puri ka pani. You have first nimbu, then you have hajma hajam, that's of ajwain. Then we have pudina, that's mint. Then jeera, that's cumin. Lehsun, that's garlic. And there's a regular mint water. Oh, I've never tried lehsun ka pani. I've already eaten in achar form or in the vegetables or in curry, but never the pani of garlic. So this is the first time I'm trying it. Mm. Mm. So next we are going to try the paratha at Lala Ji Paratha stall here. Oh.
The cart can be spotted anywhere in the lanes of Pushkar after 7 pm till 12 midnight and till the stock lasts.
So he has made the dough of whole wheat flour. Then he has added some onion, tomatoes, coriander, ginger, some bhujia, that's some keen. And here goes the paneer, that's cottage cheese. That's the grated paneer. That's the cheese cube. Now he's getting the cheese. So you have cottage cheese and then you have the cheese. That's the amul cheese going inside the paratha. Wow, that's huge. I don't know how he's going to roll it. Then some spice mix, chilies, pepper, salt, some black salt, and then everything is mixed together. But I've never tried in my life the parathas with the bhujia. Here goes the mashed potato and chili mix. How is it going to roll it? Like, it's surprisingly, it's a huge paratha. I can surely say you, I have never tried such a huge paratha in my life. That's very big. Wow. I don't know how is he going to roll it. You can see. You like, it's like evenly spread. The paratha is evenly spread and now he's rolling it. Some more flour. Here goes the our mixed veg paratha. It's really big. It's really huge. So in this paratha he has added onion, tomatoes, ginger, bhujia. Then you have cottage cheese, normal cheese. All of them mixed together with spices. And now, ye kya?
Ghee.
And then ghee.
Ye butter, ye ghee.
Acha. So we are having the paratha in certified butter. That's the ghee. It's really the calorie-rich paratha you can ever have anywhere in India. On the streets of Pushkar, you can come and try the really special paratha cooked in ghee with cheese. Wow, and now he's adding butter. So he first added clarified butter, now he's adding butter in it. It's going to be really super rich paratha with loads of calories into it. Anything with clarified butter, butter and cottage cheese is amazing. Wow, it's like pan fried. He's just checking it, just put properly or not. And now, they are cutting into small pieces, the paratha, like a pizza. It's like a pizza paratha. This is a pizza paratha. And that's the chili garlic sauce. Some mint sauce. That's a yogurt with garlic. Some onion. And masala. I have never tried such a huge paratha anywhere in India. It's such special paratha here we are having in Pushkar. You can see this is a paratha stuffed with so many delicious stuff. Most of the parathas which we eat in India is mostly in the breakfast time. It's typically a breakfast dish. But here in Pushkar you get this in the evening time after 5 o'clock. Here we have like three different kinds of dips. This is what they call garlic cheese. There's basically yogurt and garlic. Then you have chili and garlic sauce. Then the mint sauce. So this, you can see these are three different kinds of dips which you get with the paratha. Without waiting, let's just dig in now. It's simply amazing. The taste of the garlic, the melted cheese, the cottage cheese, the mashed potato. You get the flavors of everything in this paratha. It's heavenly. Now let's try with the garlic sauce. This is a traditional sauce which you get in Rajasthan anywhere you go. In fact, it goes well with the garlic sauce. Then the last one which we are having here, the green coriander sauce.
How do you like it?
The sauce is really refreshing. The mint sauce is very refreshing. So now let's dig it in the chili sauce. This is a red chili sauce with the garlic. It's like a perfectly cheesy pizza paratha for me. So if you are in Pushkar, don't miss Lalaji ke Paratha shop. Come here and try the mixed vegetable paratha. It's heavenly.
The beautiful food journey in Pushkar ended by participating in the evening aarti at Vara Ghat. This was an incredible experience.
That's how we ended our food journey in Pushkar. We definitely tried some unique and delicious street food from pizza pakwan to lafa. In the next video, Delhi Food Walks will take you on a food tour in Ajmer. Till then, keep walking, keep exploring.